Welcome to the 10th annual ISBHF World Championships from beautiful St. John's, Newfoundland and Labrador. Tonight, the final game of day one, pits five-time world champion Team Canada against Team Germany. Team Canada, as host country, would like to duplicate their past efforts at like 2001 when they took the title on home soil in Toronto. As the two teams salute each other, I'm proud to be joined by Mr. Steve Power on the broadcast tonight. Steve, Team Canada, obviously one of the pre-tournament favorites. Team Germany looking to pull off an early upset this evening.
It'll certainly be a steep hill to climb, as most of the underdogs today started out pretty strong, Elio, but towards the middle of the game, they seemed to run out of gas, and the big dogs certainly took the ball and ran with it.
Well, they say in World Championships, it's a marathon, not a sprint, and it's night one. Team Canada would love to get off to a good start tonight. Team Germany, they'd like to just build some confidence. This is the fourth game of the day. Pool A, we've already had three results. The USA defeated France, Slovakia with a big win over Team Pakistan, and two-time defending world champion Czech Republic upended Switzerland in an exciting game. Now we prepare for the host nation, five-time world champions, looking to regain their world title that they haven't held since 2007, which ironically they won in Ratingen, Germany.
Well, let's hope that the locals here, Elio, come out and support Team Canada. It looks to be pretty good so far. First game of the tournament. I think the better Team Canada does, the more support you're going to see as the week progresses. And hopefully come next weekend, you won't be able to move here at the Jack Byrne Arena.
It's a great atmosphere here at Jack Byrne Arena in St. John's, Newfoundland, Labrador. All five starters for Team Canada representing this great province of Newfoundland and Labrador, and we're getting set to go here. Final game of Pool A for day one, Team Canada, Team Germany. And we're underway from Jack Byrne Arena. Germany with possession. Number 84, Heiko Völger, off to his defense partner. Casually with the ball, you don't want to do that around Terry Ryan. He intercepts. Quick shot on Team Canada. And goaltender Maximilian Dürr makes the save. An early opportunity off the turnover forced by Team Canada.
You'll have to watch for the Canadian defensemen. They're certainly going to be activated at all times. And Paddy O'Keefe of Mount Pearl, certainly no stranger to jumping in the rush, creates that first scoring opportunity.
Exactly, and a local favorite, Justin Pender, number 24 from St. John's, is on the floor now, and he'll retrieve the ball near the blue line, but turn it over. Here comes Brandt Cook for Team Germany. Speedster on the left side, makes a quick move, inside, shoots! Big save early on. Fabio Luongo starting for Team Canada. And it's just chipped out, and the pressure is relieved as Team Germany behind Brandt Cook evens up the shot tally early.
Something a lot of the teams seem to be struggling with today, Leo, is the floor conditions here. And I don't know if the floor is bad or the players aren't used to it yet, but it's something we'll watch and see as the games progress, how players adjust.
Exactly. A lot of these players just arriving maybe have had one or two practices, really getting acclimated to the conditions here at the venues in St. John's. Carlo Ghilarducci. Ghilarducci dumps it in. Chasing it down is Chiacotti. Chiacotti with a nice nifty chip pass to Stinziani. Back to Chiacotti for a chance. Ghilarducci from the point. And that's saved by Dürr, as Dürr has been called upon to make two early saves and keep the game deadlocked. 109 in. You're watching the ISBHF World Championships from St. John's, Newfoundland, Labrador, brought to you by Bell Alliant. Chiacotti with the draw. He'll win it. Paul Roy with the shot from the point. Veteran of many world championships with Team Canada, and he'll keep it in. Ghilarducci with the shot. Dürr with the save. Turnover right in front of net. Chiacotti regains possession. Stinziani chases it down. Comes wide to Paul Roy out of Montreal, Quebec. He'll dump it in lately to Stinziani, but he's nicely bodied off the ball. And Stefan Hagen tries to gain the zone, but that'll be whistled on the offside. Team Germany would like nothing better than an early goal to build some confidence and maybe raise some shadows of a doubt into one of the pre-tournament favorites tonight.
Absolutely, as hope is a strong thing, and if Germany can get one early, they're going to start getting more hope, and with any hope at all, they're going to take this large crowd out of the game early and make it tough on Team Canada.
Crowd continues to build on opening day here. The World Championships of Ball Hockey. Yannick Labonte. Labonte tries to feed it through in a nice defensive play there by number 84, Heiko Vogler, who's made a couple early on. Morenci tries to recover. Dumps it in, Nelson Vargas-Diaz. Back to Morenci with a nice chip in behind the cycle in front of the net. Labonte has a chance and he's bodied off the ball as Germany tries to get the ball out and they're being pressured. Morenci, dipsy doodles. Feeds Labonte, but that's off to his off wing. Vulgar again with the nice play. And the German defenseman stymies Team Canada as Team Canada starts to apply the pressure. 2:17 into this opening frame.
Germany very fortunate there not to be shorthanded as Paolo Musto took a high stick to the head. A German player come out. He inadvertently hit him straight in the face with the stick. Musto seems to be okay on the bench.
Paolo Musto, one of the veterans of Team Canada, participating in his 9th World Championships for Canada. Canada again with pressure. Frechette with the shot. And Maximilian Durr again is called upon. As the pressure is starting to mount for Team Canada, they roll four lines at you relentlessly. So Team Germany's gonna be facing this and they have to win some draws. Back to Pender. Pender, nice snapshot off the glove of Durr. Germany tries to clear. Pender bodies it back in. Germany will just be glad to try to get it out. But Pender keeps it in. And for all you hockey fans out there, ball hockey, of course, it's a floating blue line. Once you gain that blue line, center line becomes the offensive zone. And the defensive team is responsible for getting the ball beyond the red line. Then the blue line is reset into the conventional offside mode. Face off at center. Back to Pender. Justin Pender, member of the Newfoundland Black Horse team, 2010 national champions and 2012 silver medalists out in Edmonton. Brant Cook, he'll feed it back and calm everything down for Vulgar. Vulgar is gonna have to log a lot of minutes, just chips it out of harm's way and a face-off. 3:01 in to this opening game. Of course, opening day is always exciting, Steve. Crowds build, you got teams that have played before or are playing tomorrow that want to come and watch. It's just a great atmosphere to get the tournament off and running.
Yeah, as you mentioned earlier, Elio, fans seem to be still streaming into the venue here, and the crowd is going to build just as the week goes on. It's going to be more exciting. It's going to start to really take hold here in Jack Byrne Arena.
Yes, for those ball hockey aficionados across the nation, best venues to have the Nationals. Newfoundland's had plenty of them, and I can attest it's a great atmosphere and it'll build during the week. Sweetland with a nice move. Goes to the forehand, scores! Andrew Sweetland out of Buena Vista, Newfoundland, opens the scoring with a nice move. Backhand, forehand, too big, too strong, 1-0.
Those are certainly some sweet hands on Sweetland. That was some move he put on that German defenseman. I don't think that defenseman still knows what happened.
That's the kind of relentless pressure that Team Canada provides. Sweetland is one of their go-to scorers, and he's going to be relied upon heavily as the tournament progresses to make plays like that, because quite frankly, as you go later in the week, the goals are minimized as the competition increases into the knockout round. O'Keefe now controls to Wah. Back to O'Keefe. Team Canada with the early 1-0 lead and the sizable advantage in zone play early on. Wah tips it into Ryan. Ryan round the boards to Escott. Escott with a nice move along the wall. He'll keep it along the wall and feed it to Terry Ryan, the 36-year-old world champion. Slaney loses it. And Germany, having difficulty getting it out. Lazy neutral zone passes will kill ya. Slaney can't get by, but he'll retrieve it. Slaney looking. Terry Ryan curls. Ryan surveying. Escott to O'Keefe with a nice pass. And Dürr makes the save. And Germany will try to get it out. And they do to number 33, Christoph Hagen. He'll dump it in. Morenci for Canada off the bench, and he'll retrieve the ball. He'll settle it down as we approach the 5-minute mark of the first period. Musto, as mentioned previously, his 10th World Championships representing our great nation of Canada. Musto surveying, and he'll get it in to Vargas Diaz. Vargas Diaz tips it ahead to Labonte. A Montreal red light combination, and Volger's there. Chipped ahead, but Morenci's there for Team Canada. He'll shoot, and that's deflected wide. Vargas Diaz gets bumped off nicely, and here come the Germans. Daniel Brendel. Brendel looking for an opening, and he'll just wheel it in and hope his teammate Benjamin Brozicek chases it down. Gilarducci, though, retains possession for Team Canada, and here comes Vargas Diaz. Volger playing a solid first period on the back end for Germany so far. Labonte shoots, and that's blocked. Musto. Labonte. Musto again. He looks for a crack and an opening in the German defense. Brandt Cook has to chase it down with pressure from Gilarducci. Oleg Seibel for Germany tries to gain the neutral zone, and it's obviously early on, Steve, that the Germans are having trouble in the neutral zone areas. Team Canada is just covering all the gaps.
You see Team Canada there, when they're, everybody is stationary on the blue line, they activate the defenseman who doesn't have the ball. They'll put the ball in a dump-in just for him. Not very often you see a defenseman retrieve a dump-in, but Canada, obviously something Coach Anidio has been working on with the squad.
Exactly. Carl Gilarducci from Île-Brassard, Quebec. The 33-year-old playing for Montreal Red Light, defending national champions. That's dumped in to the Canadian end, and they'll retreat as Germany behind Spitzer try to get some pressure. Spitzer battling it out with Mateo Stoico. Still Germany, and a chance. Shots blocked. Morello. Sandro Morello to the backhand, to the slot, off Muir's pads. Fortuitously, Muir has his pads in the right position. We have 8:37 remaining in the first period. Team Canada leads 1-0. You're watching the ISBHF World Championships of Ball Hockey from St. John's, Newfoundland, Labrador. Steve Power alongside Elio Pascuzzo. All the action brought to you by Bell Alliant as the draw takes place to the left of Muir. Draw one cleanly by Canada. O'Keefe to Pender with the blast, scores! Justin Pender, the local product, with the howitzer. And Team Canada, less than 7 minutes into this opening stanza, takes a 2-0 lead, all by the draw.
Absolutely, a late addition to Canadian roster, Chris Sparks. Unfortunately, one of the Canadian players injured yesterday in practice, and Sparks inserted into the lineup only today, makes an immediate impact in this game.
Yes, Scott Holbin from Alberta was injured in the pre-training to the tournament, and Sparks is the beneficiary, and he wins a big draw early on as Canada staked to a 2-0 lead, and here they come again. Peters, the Saskatchewan native, takes a shot. And again, Maximilian Dürr makes the save. Steve, I have a funny feeling the next 2.5 periods, I'm going to be mentioning that goalie's name quite a bit.
Absolutely, and I don't think it's going to be the last time you say a big shot from Pender on the point either. Seems like Team Canada's got 3 or 4 hammers they can put the ball back to and just let it ride.
Exactly. They have some solid shooters, Team Canada, and like we previously mentioned, they're looking at getting back their title. Chakotay with the effort. And Dürr with the save again, and Stinziani chases it down. Stinziani plays for the Montreal Black Knights in Quebec. He carries it in on his own. Cachotti, he feeds it for Sweetland, and Sweetland tries the baseball bat towards it. Sweetland, Cachotti, he'll send it back to Wah. Wah tips it ahead to Sweetland as Canada just retaining possession, patient and deliberate. Stinziani, backhand, forehand.
Is this a power play, Elio?
Seems like it, Steve. Seems like it, as Germany is really going to have to develop some sort of way to at least pressure the ball carrier, but follow that ball carrier once he releases the ball, because the give and goes are tantalizing for Team Canada early on. Volger, he'll backhand it and give it to his teammate, Osman Maras. Maras settles it down to Daniel Brendel as Germany takes a breath. We're more than halfway into this first period at Jack Byrne Arena. Team Canada with the 2-0 lead. Sweetland and Pender, the goal scorers. Germany has a chance to get it out. Morenci, Vargas Diaz, Labonte, back to Morenci. He'll feed it to Labonte, but nice back checking by the German defender Hagen. Thwarts that opportunity. And Germany will try to get it out with Hagen. Hagen, one-on-one with Stoico. He'll feed it across to Christoph Hagen. Stefan Hagen with the shot, and plays called, 6:15 remaining.
Great back check there by Paolo Musto. Germany had a late guy joining the rush, and Musto had the presence of mind to come back and break up that great scoring opportunity. Probably Germany's best chance so far in this hockey game, but the Canadian captain kept him at bay.
Team Germany hasn't had many chances in the Team Canada offensive zone, so any chances they do get, they have to take advantage of. Chances will be a premium for Germany this evening. Here comes Team Canada. They'll dump it in, and Terry Ryan will chase it down. Escott. Escott still with possession. He'll feed it back to Musto. Musto fires it just wide. Ryan chases it down. Ryan's dispossessed nicely by Robin Platz. And here comes Hagen with a chance, and he'll backhand it in. As Stoico calmly takes the ball, we'll have a delayed penalty to the Germans, as it looked like Stoico was slashed there. And Escott gains possession, shoots, and that's deflected off of Slaining and out of play. We'll have our first power play opportunity with 5:28 left. Team Canada, the beneficiary is number 33, Christoph Hagen, goes in the box for two. Another aspect of this Team Canada squad is their power play. Over the years, when they won four in a row in the early part of the century, led by coach George Gortsos, their power play was an advantage, and they made teams pay. If you took a penalty against Team Canada, you were gonna pay. Let's see what the current edition of Team Canada has in store with their power play. Luongo being pressured by the German. Wah. Frechette, back to Wah. Paul Wah, a member of those four-time world champions. Dürr, calmly, save and clear. Stevie, your best penalty killer a lot of times is the goalie.
It's got to be him. Really interested to see, Elio, watching the games earlier today, the European teams, pure skill level was unbelievable. Real curious to see where Canada is going to rank up against that.
Exactly. Some tough opponents coming up for Canada later in the week. Brant Cook runs that down with Stinziani. Stinziani relentless and possession of the ball. He'll feed it back to Wah. Frechette with the shot. Dürr calmly puts it aside, but Canada regains possession. Less than a minute left on the power play. The quarterback to Frechette, and back to Paul Roy. Over to Frechette. Frechette, one of the best shots in ball hockey, and that's who Roy wants to feed, but he'll go to Sweetland, who scores! And Sweetland has two, Canada has three. That's a power play marker. And the Germans are befuddled.
Andrew Sweetland's going to pay off more than the Vegas slot machine from that place. He's money in the bank from there, Elio.
Great, great power play execution as the quarterback feeds it a couple of times to the give and go with Frechette, and then at the right time sends it over to Sweetland. And as you mentioned, he's money in the bank when he lets that one rip. Andrew Sweetland with his second goal of the game. The native of Buena Vista, Newfoundland. 26 years old and one of the leaders on this edition of Team Canada. They're up 3-0. Germany just wants to get out of this period now. Down three with less than 4 minutes left. Dürr, he's seen a lot of action. Canada now scores! As Frechette with a shot that I don't think the German goalkeeper had any idea that he was going to shoot that ball. And he beats Maximilian Dürr. And it's 4-0 Team Canada.
The goaltender just started to open up. I think he anticipated a cross-crease pass. But Frechette had the presence of mind just to jam it home. And Frechette showing those hands of a sniper.
Germany down four now. With just under 4 minutes left in the opening frame. Team Canada, total control of this opening night game. Not surprisingly, as they are one of the pre-tournament favorites, dumped into the German end. And number 19 of Germany, Dominik Van, tries to get out, but Pender intercepts and fires. Off to the other side, number 32, Callan Wild, tries to keep it in. Nice little move by Patrick Lucians, getting a shift for the Germans, trying to make something happen, but calmly, Pender will bring it out for Canada. Pender makes a move to his left, and he'll dump it in. Number 19, Chris Mattis, tries to send it in the slot. And Canada just getting chance after chance. O'Keefe keeps it in. Along the wall, Canada tries to take possession, and Germany with an opportunity sends it up to number 18, Jamie Van. Van is back-checked by O'Keefe, and he'll take a penalty, and Luongo's called upon for one of his few first-period saves, and slashing will be the call to number 11, Patrick O'Keefe, the native of Mount Pearl. He'll take two, and Germany gets their first man advantage.
Not the first slashing penalty Patty O'Keefe's ever gotten, although that one there, he made a great play in the back-check. Looked to try to hit the stick of the German player. I don't think he made contact there, Elio, but I guess the intention was there, and that's why the call was made.
Probably the referee may have looked at the fact that he was just a stride behind, but it didn't look like a vicious slash from our end. Brand Cook now for Germany, as they need a power play goal, oh so bad. Give and go doesn't work with Hagen. Hagen, back to Cook, back to the point. Tyler Spitzer. Cook, he's looking for a point, man. He'll feed it in front for Christoph Hagen. Vogler, we've mentioned him, his name a lot. Vogler with the shot, just wide. Cook tries to get it over, but that's intercepted. Labonte is beaten to the ball by Hagen. As Germany at least retaining possession here, but they'll lose possession and regain it as Vogler. Shot by Brozicek. Good pressure, though, by the Germans on their initial power play.
Looking at the early going here, it looks like Hagen's going to be the guy they're going to be looking for to do some damage offensively for the German team. Looks to have some good offensive instincts and great position in the high slot.
And there is a little bit of chemistry there with Brandt Cook, who's a noted scorer as well. So that's something they'll look to spice up some offense. The referees for today's game from Switzerland, Sakras, and referee Koskuba representing the Czech Republic. As you well know, with a world event, the referees are also coming from all parts and are well represented here. Germany, less than a minute left in this man advantage. Seibel sends it in deep, and that's whipped around for Adam Sol. Sol will get it back to Brendel. Brendel being pressured but he'll get it to Soul. Soul is displaced by Wild. And now we're going to have a holding the stick penalty as Adam Soul trying to retain possession on the power play is going to be given a 2-minute infraction for holding the stick.
So we'll have some 4-on-4 here for the next 37 seconds. Team Canada going to get a late power play opportunity after that. Wonder if we're going to see Sweetland and Frechette again.
Most likely, most likely. Germany has to get out of this period with the scoreline at the minimum 4-0. It's a tall task to ask them to beat Team Canada tonight, but if they want to remain competitive for the remainder of the evening, they will have to get out of this period unscathed. 4-on-4 hockey. Van, he'll make a nice move, but Ghilarducci is equal to the task on the penalty kill. He's displaced by Van, who doesn't give up, and Pender, always stable and strong back there. Stinziani. Ghilarducci with the shot, just wide. Morenci from a bad angle, can't beat Dürr, and the players congregate in front of the net with 43 seconds left in the first period.
Morenci looks to be a little spark bug for this Canadian team. Very small in stature, but looks like he's a big, big player. Not afraid to stick his nose in there at all.
No, he's a fire plug there. Dominic Morenci, player on the Montreal Red Light team, defending national champions in Canada, 8-time national champions, Montreal Red Light. And he'll be on there with Yannick Labonte. Germany retains possession. Vogler tries to flip it up, and it's called on the offside as number 77, Paul Roy, tried to bat that one, but he put it into his own end on the delay.
Team Canada getting set to go to the power play now. 3 seconds remain to 4-on-4. 34 seconds left to go here in the first. Team Canada like to finish this period strong with a statement goal, if nothing else.
Exactly. They'd love to go in the change room, up by 5. And they'll take the power play with 30 seconds left as O'Keefe runs over. Pender now. Justin Pender, 20 seconds, he'll dump it in. And Vargas Diaz is there first for Canada. Pressured by Vogler to Morenci. Morenci approaching the 10-second mark, and a shot is attempted as Yannick Labonte. Pender shoots, scores! Automatic when it gets on that guy's stick. Justin Pender with 2. He'll match Sweetland's 2. And it's 5-0 with 2 seconds remaining in the first.
When Justin Pender quits his ball hockey career, he can get a job in the bomb squad, because that's a bomb from the point. No other word for it, just an absolute rocket off the stick of Justin Pender.
Justin Pender, one of the mainstays on the Canadian defense. He'll be counted on not only for his defensive presence, but to supply from offense. And he has delivered here as the referee will drop the ball and play out this final 2 seconds of the first period. And Germany will have to regroup in the change room as the buzzer sounds at the end of the first period. The score, Team Canada 5, Team Germany 0. You're watching the 10th edition of the ISBHF World Ball Hockey Championships from St. John's, Newfoundland, brought to you by Bell Alliance. We'll be back with our first period intermission. Canada 5, Germany nothing.
I'm not going to stop.
Welcome back to Jack Byrne Arena during the first intermission. Proud to be joined by ISBHF President, Mr. George Gortzos. And George, you must be proud that this tournament opening day is off and running and great action at both venues.
You know, we're very proud. Today we had our A and B pool play, and one of the great results was Israel playing its first ever game with some Israeli boys from back home in Israel and some from Canada, tying Italy 3-3, which was a historical occurrence.
Excellent result there. And also the other result from the B pool, where the Cayman Islands came up with a big win, beating Great Britain. So if early indications are anything, that should be a very competitive pool. Of course, with the A pool, you're here watching Team Canada play Team Germany, but of course the two-time defending champions, Czech Republic, won both of their titles, once in Slovakia, three titles, twice in Czech Republic, once in Slovakia. They'd like nothing better than to win their fourth on Canadian soil.
Well, I think winning at their arch rivals country in Canada would be great. And you know, Elio, one of the things that I've noticed here at the A pool is the great depth. I've never seen so many good teams. Switzerland's improved, Pakistan's improved, the Germans are, this is their first time they're playing together, they're improved, you know, the Greeks are improved, and then USA has come with a phenomenal team, and then you got the Czechs, the Slovaks, the Canadians, and Portugal. It's an amazing division. I think every game's going to be a big game.
Exactly, exactly. Well, thank you very much, Mr. George Gortzos. He'll be joining us later in the week as the games get more intense. As we get set for the second period here, Team Canada totally dominating the first period, beating Team Germany, leading Team Germany 5-0, and the second period starts as the first period ended with a Team Canada possession. Cook for Germany now as they try to come out. Sol deflected off Pender's stick in the neutral zone and an early face-off in the second period. Of course, lots of action taking place all week, Steve, at two venues, Jack Byrne Arena and Glacier Arena in Mount Pearl. Should be a lot of great action, A pool, B pool, and of course, the Women's World Championships.
Hopefully we'll get a lot of support here in the St. John's area and come out and see some great action between all these athletes from the various countries around the world. And the ladies, for sure, they'll surprise a lot of people with their skill level.
Exactly, and they'll get out underway. The Women's Championship starts Tuesday as Escott chases down that dump-in. Escott being pressured by number 85, Maris. Maris, relentless, trying to displace Escott, but Escott keeps possession to Ryan. Terry Ryan feeds Escott for the shot, and that's deflected by Vogler. Cook chases it down. Germany with a little more energy here, starting the second. Daou with the backhand. Terry Ryan behind the net. He'll feed Daou. Nice defensive play by the German defender, but to no avail as Ryan sends it along the wall. O'Keefe is bumped off the ball by Maris. Maris playing a physical brand of hockey tonight for Germany. Spitzer sends it out, and Pender takes over to O'Keefe. Here comes Canada again. Shot! Daou. Don't even think Maximilian Durr saw that, and he's glad it went out of play.
I don't know if a ball hockey ball can dent the crossbar, but if it could, that's the one there. That was a bullet.
Fans and players alike had no idea where that ball went as Daou with the rocket, and he'll take the draw. just outside the blue line. 13:25 remaining in the second period. Musto to Stoiko. Stoiko, one of the impressive young defensemen on the Team Canada squad, bursts through for a chance and tries to make one move too many. And nice defensive play by the German defender, but he'll give it back up to Frechette, who shoots just wide. Musto battling with Brendel. He'll keep it in. Number 35, Morello. Morello back to Musto. Musto, the patient one, to Frechette. Frechette tries to make a pass, but that's chipped into the corner. But Daou wins that battle. Jonathan Daou tries a give and go with Frechette, and it'll get back to Frechette, but he can't corral it. And number 77, Lucience, tries to get it out. Stoiko tries another rush and another move, but again, one move too many, and the Germans are there. Here comes number 61, Brozicek, tries to get by Musto. He can't. Stoiko now at the end of a long shift, as Stinziani is stood up by number 12, Alexander Kozic. And Kozic will get the penalty. Interference.
Kozic fell down on the play, but his gloves came up in the face of Stinziani. Good call there by the official. Stinziani clearly impeded as he pushed the ball by.
Exactly. That was a two-on-one, if not a three-on-one in the making. And Canada will go on another power play. 2:45 into the second period. 5-0. Team Canada leads their opening game in Pool A of the World Championships. Joining them in Pool A, Slovakia, a former world champion, Greece, and Pakistan. Paul Ra sends it in, but Vogler is there. Spitzer. Frechette with a nice pass. Sweetland, two goals so far. Back to the point. Canada, methodical on their power play. Frechette with the shot. Nice save, dear. They battle along the boards. Canada, with the odd man advantage, wins the battle along the boards. And Frechette to the quarterback. Sweetland with the blast. And a nice save by Deer as he gets the blocker out there, makes the save 45 seconds into the power play. Team Canada with a line change. They just have so many weapons at their disposal.
With Frechette and Sweetland on their one-time sides, just got to make you wonder when you're a kid, why do you want to be a goalie? How do you face the likes of that? That's unbelievable. Those one-time shots for Team Canada, two fantastic weapons to have here on the power play.
As we all say, it takes a special breed to become a goalie. And they face a lot of shot. Morenci all alone to the backhand. And what a save! Outstanding goaltending by Maximilian Dürr as he robs Morenci, who had him beat. And say what you want about the scoreline, this goalie for Germany is their best player.
That was pure robbery there, Elio. And the hometown fans here in St. John's gave the goaltender a real nice round of applause after that one.
Excellent, excellent save there. And they needed it as Pender sends it over wide to Yannick Labonte. Pender with the shot, and that's blocked by Spitzer. Nice sacrifice there by the German defender, and he'll come off after a well-deserved penalty-killing shift. Pender. He'll just chip it in deep for the speed of Vargas Diaz. Sends it around to Yannick Labonte. Tries to send it in front, but that's stopped. Pender. Morenci. Morenci fakes a shot, gets it into the slot. Daou with an opportunity, but he can't get a shot off. And Luongo feed it up to Pender. Daou with a break. Labonte with the back pass. Vargas Diaz gobbles up the junk. And it's 6-0 on a power play goal for Team Canada, as it looked like the pass wasn't going to succeed, but the follow-up man took care of business.
Just too much too soon, Team Canada. You cannot give these guys power plays. One thing I noticed, though, it's going to be real interesting to see later on this week. Canada likes to approach the blue line and make a high dump in and then go chase it. And I noticed today, Team Pakistan tried the same thing against Slovakia, but it didn't work. So it's going to be real interesting to see, will Canada change, or is that the plan going forward?
Exactly. Excellent point, because they may have to go to a plan B and plan C on their execution to get the power play zone time. As Germany, even at 5-on-5, but down 6-0 to Team Canada, who's come out on opening night to play. Terry Ryan, the veteran from Mount Pearl. He'll get intercepted. And Vogler, who's played a great game, sends it down. And it's called on the icing. Of course, Terry Ryan, a member of a national championship Newfoundland Black Horse team, and of course, of Team Canada for many years. Really look forward to this tournament being in his home province.
Real feel-good story. Terry Ryan just being able to play right now. Suffered a major injury this past winter playing ice hockey. Had a collapsed lung, broken ribs. Now, Terry really had his heart set on playing for Team Canada. Worked really hard to be a part of the squad.
Yep, his desire and sacrifice second to none in the sport, as there's a nice play as Gilard Ducci is the benefactor as Ryan starts that playoff along the wall, and it ends up on Gilard Ducci's stick in the slot, and it's a 7th spot for Team Canada.
This Gilard Ducci, I don't know if there's a new position being created in ball hockey called Rover, but if there was, it's him. He's all over the place. He's in front of the net. He's on the point. I don't think you can stop this guy. I really like this kid.
Gilard Ducci, one of the young up-and-coming players, only 24 years of age. Great player, looks like a keeper for many Team Canada additions. Terry Ryan and Slaney on the assists. And Team Canada just keeps pouring it on. Less than 10 minutes remaining in the second period. Opening day here at the ISBHF World Championships in St. John's, Newfoundland, Labrador. Your coverage brought to you by Bell Alliant, and we're proud to bring it to you. Dürr behind the net. Blindly sends it, and Stinziani tries to catch him off guard with the backhand to no avail. Musto keeps it in. Nice little chip ahead to Stinziani. He tries to backhand it through, and Germany happy to ice it. Of course, this is the second time Canada has hosted the World Ball Hockey Championships. In 2001, the city of Toronto was host. Canada winning the World Championships in overtime in the final over the Czech Republic.
Canada certainly counting on that home cooking to bring home a second world title.
As mentioned previously, they have won this tournament 5 times, but have yet to win it since 2007. Ironically, the tournament being held there in Germany back in 07. Czech Republic won it twice in a row. Stoiko continues with the moves. Stinziani with the backhand, and Dürr equal to the task as he's made plenty of saves. A nice play by Stoiko to Stinziani, and Stinziani using that backhand effectively.
Yeah, really, he got rid of that backhand really quick. He's a right-handed shot there. That's him back in the net, but I was impressed how quick he got rid of it on his backhand. That's a great, great hands on Michael Stinziani.
One of the top players in the country, Mr. Stinziani, plays for the Montreal Black Knights in Montreal, Quebec, national champion as well. Dürr tries to send it over to Brant Cook, and Cook chips it ahead for Spitzer, gets out of the zone, but Musto, lots of space to Ciccotti. Stinziani now as Canada, still with the pressure. Cacciotti ends up back to the point to number 77, Paul Roy. Stefan Ciccotti still with the possession. He's going to go all alone in the slot. Stinziani there to help him out. As Germany just scrambling here, and Sweetland with the ball. He'd like nothing better than to pop a hat trick at home. Roy with the shot, and that is deflected and out of play.
Players seem to be really dangerous coming around the net on their forehand side, especially saw it today in the Czech Republic game. The Canadian player chose not to shoot in that opportunity, but really tough for ball hockey players to cover that man coming around the net without taking a penalty. You can't do it, especially against this real tough Team Canada power play.
Exactly. Team Canada, with so many players they have at their disposal, their depth is something that could carry them in this tournament. Morenci tries to feed it into the slot, but it goes right through. And Durr freezes it again. 7:41 remaining, second period. Opening day at the World Championships of Ball Hockey. The International Street and Ball Hockey Federation proud to be here in St. John's, Newfoundland, Labrador. Ra to Morenci. Morenci wheeling, dealing. Sends it to Labonte, who backhands it to our defenseman turned forward, Ghilarducci.
Rover.
Morenci. Canada still with the pressure. As Germany just looking for some sort of possession. Vargas Diaz. He'll feed Ghilarducci in his familiar spot, and he shoots it just wide. Vargas Diaz again. Surveying. Keeping possession. Chips it back to Morenci. Nice give and go to Vargas Diaz. He'll send it over, and that doesn't go in, but the follow-up does as Ghilarducci scores, and it's 8-0 Canada.
Labonte should get a lot of credit on that goal. He was having an epic battle in front of the net with the German defenseman. Could have been penalties called either way. Referees whistles in the pocket, and Ghilarducci, the recipient of a lot of hard work there by Labonte in front of the net.
Yes, the officials were letting a little bit go there in front of the net as Germany is just having difficulty keeping up with this Canadian attack, which isn't surprising based on the fact that the A pool, Canada, Czech Republic, Slovakia, and the United States are the favorites. And Canada showing why as we approach the 7-minute mark in the second period. A lot of pressure in the zone, as fatigue also may be a factor for this German squad, and that sent into the crowd and out of play. And Steve, we have to talk about that. You're also looking at a German team down 8 goals. Not only are they down by the score, but fatigue may also come into play down 8.
I got to tell you, Leo, I was a little bit worried before this game. And I think it's fortunate that Canada were playing, I guess it's safe to say now, a weaker opponent. Team Canada practiced for 4 hours and played an exhibition game in less than 24 hours before this game. Probably looks good right now on an 8-0 score, but against a tougher team, you got to wonder if fatigue would be a factor in that case.
Exactly. And in Canada's scheduling, did they do that schedule based on the fact that they knew they were going to play one of the lesser opponents in the A pool?
Absolutely. You got to think the coaching staff is pretty smart, and they set it up that way, no doubt.
Exactly, because they have some big games coming up. Tomorrow night, they'll take on Team Greece right here at Jack Byrne Arena. And Tuesday night, former world champion Slovakia, as Canada keeps on the pressure. So Canada does have some more difficult opponents coming up on their schedule. And that Canada-Slovakia game has been circled on the calendar. And then they'll finish up their round-robin portion on Wednesday versus Pakistan before they head into the medal round. 6 minutes remaining, second period. Bella Lyon, proud to bring you the ISBHF World Ball Hockey Championships from St. John's, Newfoundland, Labrador. Jack Byrne Arena, the beautiful venue. Steve Power and Elio Pascuzzo, glad to be alongside bringing you the action. Where we left it, Canada with possession as Slaney loses it. And a 2-on-1, Brant Cook with speed. Tries to get by Musto, does, but he can't get a shot towards Luongo. Ryan chips it out nicely. Escott with a trailing Slaney. Soul. Ryan takes over possession. Escott, relentless this line in their forechecking. Evan Peters now off the bench. Back to Musto. Shoots. That's blocked by Vogler. And again, Brant Cook will try to stick handle his way into the Canadian zone. He'll take a shot. And that's easily stopped by Fabio Luongo, who hasn't had a lot of action, the native of Montreal, Quebec.
Yeah, that's the first shot on Luongo in quite some time for the German team. Just had a 2-on-1 materialize a couple of minutes before, but no shot on net. It's bad enough being down 8-0. You got to take advantage of a 2-on-1. You got to get the ball to the crease.
Yep. Those, like we said before, any chances Germany were to get this evening, they'd have to take advantage of them. But we do know one thing. Vogler's played a strong game on the back end despite the score for Germany. We've already mentioned the accolades for goaltender Dürer. And even Spitzer, number four, has shown a lot of energy. Despite the scoreline, these players have come to play this evening. Faceoff will come outside the Canadian blue line. Vargas Diaz chips it ahead, and Sparks sends it back to Vargas Diaz, who tries to get Peters in front of the net. Sparks. He'll wrist it, and that'll just go wide along the boards. He'll send it back to Peters. Canada with control behind the net. Peters tries to hit Sparks. That's chased down by Ghilarducci. He'll get it back to Peters. Peters shoots. Dürer turns that aside. Peters dueling with Vogler. Sparks with the support along the wall. Peters, yeoman's work in the Germany end. As Canada, lots of depth, lots of talent, imposing their will. Delayed offside to Germany, so Ghilarducci will have time. He'll send it to Vargas Diaz, to Sparks. Sparks shoots, whistles wide. Sweetland, two goals already tonight. He loses it. O'Keefe can't keep it in, but Stoico does. And he'll bank it off the boards to himself and settle everything down to the veteran. Partner as it's sent deep. Platz, Robin Platz for Germany. One on two. As Germany continues to try to get it out with the Hagen boys. Hagen chases down the defender. Cacciotti to Stinziani. He's bodied. Back to Cacciotti. He'll try to go to the backhand, but he can as Hagen makes a nice play defensively. Over to Christoff Hagen. He'll get it safely out of the zone. O'Keefe. Another native of Mount Pearl. He'll give and go with his partner and move forward. Approaching the 3 minute remaining mark of the second period. 8-0 Team Canada. Hagen displaced, but his partner will be there to help him out, but he'll give it right back to Team Canada. Stinziani sends it to the net, veered off into the corner by goaltender Dürer. Nice move as the Canadian forward tries to pop another one sneakily, and they'll send it down. Luongo will play it as Germany's on a line change. Paul Rohr. Marenzi. Vargas Diaz. Labonte. Nice save by Maximilian Dürer. Again, Marenzi. He'll dipsy doodle and try to get it to Vargas Diaz. Kept in by Wild nicely. Marenzi again. Marenzi with a nice dipsy-doodle move, but one move too many. Wild pinching in from his defense position, and Germany just clears it out. Germany retains possession, but it's called on the glove pass, I believe. Although they could have been called for too many men because they were hovering not only on six, but seven on the floor.
2:05 left to go here in the second period. Seems like the game's starting to slow down a little. I don't know if Canada's taking her foot off the gas, but seems like it's got that feeling.
They're well in control of this game, and maybe it's time to work on rolling the lines and just staying healthy to prepare for game two, as they are well in control of this opening game. Wild. He'll take his time and just send it just wide of the net as Morello was there. Brozicek chases it down for Germany. Nice play off the boards, and they'll gain the zone as Brendel slips and falls. Lucens tries to keep it in, and that sends Maris back. Dürer sends it out, but he'll turn it over to Morello. Morello. Daou. Back to Morello. Loose. Scores. Morello, the sportsman that he is, just waits to make sure the goalie's okay, as it looked like the goaltender was injured during that play. But a nice play by Morello and Daou, and Canada gets their ninth of the game. Maximilian Durr, the German goalie, has faced a lot of balls tonight. And to his credit, who can blame him for taking a couple of seconds to recruit? Let's just hope he's okay.
I think the most nervous guy in the building right now is number 34 on the German bench, the other goaltender. I don't think he wants any part of this.
As I go to my trusted roster sheet, Michael Eisenschmidt is the man that's looking at the coach and hasn't taken his eyes off the coach for the last 30 seconds.
No, sir, Leo. I think he's saying to coach, I'm all right here, buddy. Durr, you get up. I'm going to stay.
As all the time will be taken, that's necessary to make sure this goalie, who despite the scoreline, Steve, has played a great game and made probably so far, even though it's opening day, the save of the tournament.
Absolutely.
Off Morenci.
He's been fantastic for his German team, kept him in it as much as he can. One thing I've noticed in this sport of ball hockey for the uninitiated, even though it's a floating blue line and the defensemen stay back on the red, when the defending team moves the ball up to the boards to their teammate, it's amazing how quick the gap is closed by the defenseman. You would think you have time to stop the ball, turn around, go out, but the defensemen just jump up on you so quick, especially Canada, Slovakia, the United States, the Czech Republic. There's absolutely no time here. The speed of this game is unbelievable at a high level.
And those defensemen that pinch in to, you know, keep the zone, they're also benefited by some very active forwards, that third forward who's anticipating to cover. So they have the peace of mind that they can clog up the neutral zone, still keep the zone, and know that someone will be covering their back on the way in.
I've spoken earlier about the skill of the Europeans and the skill of the Canadian team, but make no doubt, these guys play very systematic hockey. They know where they're supposed to be and when.
Exactly, and a lot of these teams, pre-tournament, preparation, you know, a team like Canada, they've worked on a few things, but they also have the advantage of players that play on their club teams together for many years. And that, for example, like a team like Montreal Red Light, the Labonte line, they've been playing together for years, so that benefits them also.
Absolutely. Chemistry is going to be a big thing in a short-term event. And the more teams generally get together as the week goes on, you'll see the chemistry grow. Canada with an advantage, like you say, having that natural chemistry among some players.
We're back. 1:13 remaining, second period. Stoiko, who's made quite a few moves through the offensive zone, doesn't succeed that time, but his partner, Paolo Musto, is there. And here comes Canada. Ryan, the veteran, with speed. Tries to leave it back for Slaney, but that's nicely anticipated by the German defender. Cook shoots, fakes the shot, tries to hit Spitzer. With a shot like he has, might have been more advantageous to test Luongo on that one. Musto, patient, back to Stoiko, and they'll regroup as the Ryan line cycles around and gives some options to the veteran, Paolo Musto, playing in his 10th World Championships for Team Canada. He takes a shot, and Durr makes the save. German player with the possession, number 12, and he's tripped. Kozic is tripped by Terry Ryan, and he'll go for two for tripping. So Germany will go to the power play late in the second period. 16.8 seconds remaining. Terry Ryan, 2 minutes for tripping, and a glorious opportunity for Germany if they can somehow get possession and get it into the zone, but at least they'll most likely go into the third period with a man advantage.
Terry Ryan going to a place he's quite familiar with in the hockey world, and I don't know how glorious it is to score at 9-1, but I'm sure Team Germany would love to break that goose egg and get on the board.
Right now, the victory for Germany this evening would be one goal. That's all they're looking for, is just one goal, something to give their spirits a boost heading into tomorrow and day two. Vogler chips it in, and Cook with the nice chip up all alone, and Luongo with the nice pad save. And Canada, shorthanded, will end the period. Another period dominated by Team Canada. First period, they score 5. However, this period, they get 4. The score at the end of the second period on opening day at the ISBHF World Championships of Ball Hockey in St. John, Newfoundland, Labrador. Team Canada, 9. Team Germany, 0. All your action brought to you by Bell Alliance, and we'll join you shortly with our second intermission. Welcome back to Jack Byrne Arena, our second intermission with Team Canada firmly in control. We're proud to have alongside in the booth Mr. Sandro Morello, a member of many Team Canada editions. And how does it feel representing Canada here in your great country?
Well, it's always a big honor just to play for Canada, but to be here in Newfoundland, which is probably the best place in Canada to have a ball hockey tournament because they're so passionate, and you see all the people here tonight for the first game. It was always a dream to play hockey, you know, NHL first, but this is the second best, I guess. And to represent your country, it's always an honor.
Exactly, and you have a lot of experience representing Team Canada on the world stage in ball hockey. How does it feel this time around where you see these young players and you see yourself in their eyes where you were back then? Now they're representing the country and everything you can add to show them maybe the path to what the future holds.
Yeah, I think that's probably my role here since I've been around so long, you know, and keep the guys loose. And since you've been around a long time, obviously I remember my first year, I was really nervous. But we have a great bunch of young guys that doesn't seem to affect them at all. So it's a lot of fun. You think back at when you started and you see it in their eyes as well. So it's really a great thing to see.
Obviously, Team Canada is one of the favorites in this tournament. We know that the two-time defending champion, Czech Republic, Slovakia, the United States. In terms of your team, how does it benefit and help you that you have so many familiar faces, you know, coming from the great province of Quebec and so many national championships, along with some of the players from Newfoundland, of that chemistry that maybe helps in a week-long tournament?
I think it's a huge asset because, you know, normally these tournaments, if you get guys from all across Canada, we practice a couple times before the tournament, and that's it. Having played with most of these guys is a big benefit because I know the Europeans, they practice a lot more. They do tournaments together. With their close proximity, they have a chance to really play together, so they have that advantage. But this year here in our hometown, and we have so many Quebec guys and Newfoundland guys, and they're playing together, so it's gonna gel quicker, I think.
Great. Well, it was a pleasure talking to you. Sandro Morello, one of the great ambassadors and players in the history of our nation, and it was a pleasure to have him. Good luck in the third period.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Pretty good though.
Are you doing all the games?
Yeah.
gifts. The winner is a 50-50 contest.
What?
50-50, dog.
When they announce it, you mean?
No, can you do it on camera?
This is good, but I'm not sure how you're going to do it.
I'll leave it right here on YouTube.
You're going to you make the announcement for the 50-50, you mean? Yeah, it'd be better. Are you doing it after? You're doing it now, are you? When do you do it? Oh, that'll be during the third period.
Yeah.
No, but, no, I'll be following the book then.
Huh?
I'll be following the game then.
Oh, yeah, okay.
Yeah. It was now within the next about one third period, but during the third period, I don't think so. I'm just the picky guy.
Okay.
Welcome back to Jack Byrne Arena, the ISBHF World Ball Hockey Championships, live from St. John's, Newfoundland, Labrador, brought to you by Bell Alliance, Team Canada on opening day against Team Germany, heading into the third period with a comfortable 9-goal lead. From the start, Team Canada has been too strong, too tough, and Germany would just like to get out of this game with a marker against Team Canada. Of course, on Team Canada's side, they just want to keep their flow consistent as they prepare for their second round robin game on Monday versus Team Greece. We're underway in the third period. Germany still with the remnants of that power play, a minute and 30 plus left, and that's sent in deep by Brozicek, and Luongo doesn't take a chance, freezes it, and the whistle is blown before he releases it to Ghilarducci. Of course, this tournament goes right till next Sunday, June the 9th. Action at Mount Pearl Glacier Arena. And of course, here at Jack Byrne, as a nice shot by Brant Cook off the draw, nicely won by Brozicek. And Cook is turned aside by Fabio Luongo, the 26-year-old goaltender from Montreal, Quebec. And here comes Ghilarducci. He's the goal scorer tonight, and he has no visions of giving up this ball on the penalty kill. He'll battle with Brozicek, but Brozicek calmly leaves it for Vogler, and Germany will regroup. Spitzer back to Vogler. Vogler sends it over to Brozicek. Brozicek backhands it in deep as Christoph Hagen. Johnny on the spot. Spitzer. Back to Vogler. Spitzer with the shot. Luongo, nice save with the left arm, and he'll freeze the ball with 41 seconds in this man advantage remaining for Team Germany. Maybe a win, Steve, would be a goal for Germany that, you know, quite frankly, not much to the regular viewer, but to the team in that dressing room could be huge.
Yeah, it's got to be something they can take and build on going forward, because there's going to be teams they're going to be competitive with. You can tell there's some skill, there's some talent. It's just Team Canada too much too soon.
Well put. Opening day at the World Championships, too much too soon. Team Canada tonight. But here comes Germany. Less than 30 seconds left on the power play. Stinziani, he'll calmly circle, slip, slide, and still retain possession. But he can't get it out, as number 8, Seibel, sends it over to 19, Van. Van, off to the side to Brendel. Brendel, trying to get an opening there. Cook, he's looking for a way to get that wrist shot off, and he will. And that gets through, but turned aside. Stinziani, bodies his opponent off the ball and sends it down. And Vargas Diaz, with tons of speed, shorthanded, tracks it down. We're 5-on-5. He'll send it back to Ryan, who lets one rip. Ryan battling along the boards with Seibel. Van whips it around. And Cook. Cook with the nice move. Cook, 1-on-2, though, is too many to handle on this powerful squad as Musto sends it up to Sweetland. Sweetland looking for the trailer. Hits Peters. Peters shoots wide. Pender corrals it, backs up into the neutral zone. Lots of room, lots of space. Sweetland. As Canada starting to regain their dominance, they establish in the first two periods. Cacciotti, down low to Peters. Peters sends it in front to no avail. Rozicek bodied off the ball by Peters. Still battling is Matas. Matas loses the ball, but Vogler's there. And Vogler will calmly feed Cook. Cook, at the end of a long shift, will just dump it in, but he won't get there as Pender gloves it. And we'll have a penalty called on the hook to number 27, Peters, on the back check. Didn't look harmless, but the referee saw it differently from his position.
Yeah, when you're up 9-0, that's an easy call for the referee to make. That just keeps people interested here. 11:56 left to go in the third period. Germany, another chance to break that goose egg here on the power play. You can see the German goaltender. He's just exhausted down the corner. I mean, he's going to go to sleep tonight having nightmares about Orange the way this is going.
Yes, he's faced a lot of shots, made some good saves, but too much. As Spitzer off the draw. Shot blocked by Morello, our second intermission guest, and he'll send it down.
How about that, Morello? 9-0 going down, taking that shot block. These guys are tough.
One of the true great players in Canadian ball hockey history, Sandro Morello. Spitzer sends it in, and he'll go against Benter in the corner. Pender battling with O'Keefe. Spitzer, as Hagen and O'Keefe have it at each other. Vogler fans, and that's tipped ahead by Daou. 2-on-1, shorthanded. Daou trying to feed Morello, but he can't. Durr turns it over behind the net. Brozicek sends it back to Van, and Van calmly brings it up, approaching the 1 minute mark of this power play. Brozicek sends it over to Van, but off the mark, and O'Keefe will calmly send it down. Germany in dire need for their confidence of something to take to tomorrow. Sends it in. Wild will send it right back, and Germany retreats.
Gotta say, really impressed here with the Team Canada coaching staff, using all the elements on the bench. Starting to see guys play all roles and situations. And like you said, probably thinking ahead now a little in the schedule. They need one more goal. Pretty important the way the score's been going today to get that 10th goal. But I think they're looking ahead and they're trying to use all the items they got in the toolbox.
Exactly. That 10-goal spread is the maximum a result can be achieved. So you can win by more than 10 goals, but the final score will only go on record as a 10-goal spread. So Canada will want to make sure they get there. But Vogler, 8 seconds left on the power play. Cook. Cook takes a snapshot, but that's blocked. Back to Vogler. He'll shoot. Luongo with the save, and he'll freeze it.
I gotta say, Luongo looks really sharp here for a guy, not getting a lot of work. Notice some of the other goaltenders today, they struggled, they weren't focused in the game. But this Luongo, he seems very focused. No rebounds, great control, looking really sharp for Canada.
Exactly. For a goalie who hasn't faced a lot of shots, the shots that he has faced, he's been steady, made the saves, and kept Germany without a goal scored. As number 22, Stefan Hagen, gets set to take the draw. 5-on-5 hockey under 10 minutes remaining in the third period on opening day here at Jack Byrne Arena. As that ball is sent just beyond the outstretched arms of Terry Ryan and called on the icing. Of course, Team Canada, we've mentioned their lineup very strong. Their coaching staff's led by head coach Tony Iannito from Laval, Quebec. General manager Assistant GM Mike Schweigart from Delta, British Columbia. The rest of the coaching staff, Ian Moores from Bay Roberts, Newfoundland, Labrador. Jason Biani from Irishtown, New Brunswick. Athletic therapist Matthew Halverson from Delta, British Columbia. And trainer David Roper from nearby Mount Pearl. As Canada breaks in all alone with another opportunity, and that's foiled. Here comes Germany, two men strong. Seibel tries to get it in, and the referee's gonna call a slash on Ghilarducci for Canada as he was over-aggressive against Hagen.
Ghilarducci's been up forward, he's been back on defense, just as well to go to the penalty box. It's the only place he hasn't been tonight. Great performance by this Ghilarducci. Gotta say again, very impressed with his play.
Yes, one of the up-and-coming players on this national program. As Germany, another power play opportunity. It's their third in succession, and they have to retreat. Of course, the German team, their head coach, Ray Cook, and their manager, as there's a giveaway. And Durr makes a save, but he's gonna be asked upon to make one save too many as Vargas Diaz puts away the giveaway. As unfortunate circumstances, maybe fatigue, maybe just too much Canada, and they get two chances on the power play, and the second one they don't make any mistakes.
It's one way to make a 10-0 game interesting. Turn the puck over to player, make a miraculous save. Rebound comes out though. Like the theme of the night, too much too soon. This Canadian team just can't be handled by this German squad on this night for sure.
Exactly. So Vargas Diaz gives Canada the 10-goal lead that they were looking for as things get intense along the boards, and Morenci sends it down. Vogler sends it ahead, and we're going to have another penalty as we're going to have a cross-checking call, and I believe it's to Team Canada, number 24, Justin Pender. He'll take the penalty, and Germany will go to a 5-on-3.
Some of these referees are going to have to go in for rotator cuff surgery from putting their arm up and down for penalties after this week. It's a steady stream to the box, but hey, the referee's got to keep control. The game's a high score. You don't want it to get it out of hand. Nothing wrong with it. Great job by the officials.
Exactly. Excellent job by the officiating crew tonight handling this game. The officiating crew representing Switzerland and the Czech Republic here for this Canada-Germany encounter. 5-on-3 for 1:16. Vogler. They'll gain the zone. And Brandt Cook, or control the ball. And he'll play the quarterback position here. Vogler. He'll fire it, and that'll just go wide. And Jamie Vaughn gets possession. Cook fakes the shot to Vogler. Vogler down low to Van. Vogler back to Van. He's looking for Vogler, but he'll fake the pass and shoot. And Luongo searching for the ball, and he finds it under the maze and freezes it with 37 seconds left on the 5-on-3.
Those five players Germany just had on the floor in certainly don't lack in size. That's a big five guys there. You think they might want to put the ball to the net a little more and use their size advantage. Canada were going with three penalty killers. Not really big in stature. I thought Germany probably could have used that to an advantage a little more than they did.
Yes, they should have put some more traffic in front of the net because they definitely have some big boys. Van to Cook. Back to Van. Van trying to spread out, but he'll lose possession. And Stinziani circles and stops. And he'll try to kill some more time down two men. And he'll calmly send it in as we approach less than 20 seconds left in the two-man advantage. They will still have 50 seconds left in the one-man advantage. Cook. Chips it off, but nobody's running. Wild tips it back, and Spitzer keeps it in nicely. Spitzer surveying. He'll feed it off to the right side. But good defensive play by Stoico. Germany scrambling, but Cook retains possession. Back to Spitzer. He'll shoot, and that's blocked by Ghilarducci. Grosjack. Spitzer shoots. Longwood to save. Rebound comes out, and Ghilarducci, down a man with 20 seconds left, will wait and fire and get off. As Canada, 10 seconds away from successfully killing off this 5-on-3 disadvantage. Spitzer chips it in and chases it down. Yannick Labonte. He'll feed it. Cross floor for Cacciotti. Cacciotti with speed. Backhand, forehand, but Cook back checks nicely. Sends it into the slot, back to the point. O'Keefe sends it towards the net, and that's deflected on the high stick, and that'll be blown dead, and the draw will come outside with 6:14 remaining in the third period.
Nice play by O'Keefe there just to get a quick shot in on the goal. Deflected by a high stick. Tough call to make there. The referee, Johnny, on the spot and saw it there. The faceoff will come outside. Team Canada in the driver's seat. Total control, looking ahead now to tomorrow's matchup against Greece.
Yep, Steve, if you're the coaching staff of Team Canada, this is exactly what you wanted. 10-goal spread, no goals against, relatively healthy. This is exactly what the coaching staff needed from their opening night venture versus Germany. Morello sends it to Daou, takes a shot. Endure with the save. Morello still with the ball. He'll send it in the slot, and Vogler intercepts. Mattis back to Vogler. Vogler's logged a lot of minutes in this game. That's waved off nicely by the officials with 5:35 left. Ball is sent back to Daou to Frechette. Frechette can't get by Lucentz. Whipped around to the side where Gaelhofer chases it down for Canada. Musto now. Nicely up to Ryan, who stumbles. Still hustles in. Ryan tips it back to Escott. Escott looks for Ryan, who deflects it towards Slaney. And Durr sends it to the corner. Slaney, big, strong, tough to get him off the ball. Still with possession. To Ryan. Ryan will tip it ahead and try to get Stoiko, who bats it out of the air. And that goes just wide. Stoiko still. Canada working it behind the net, behind Ryan. Ryan stumbles, recovers. He's taken down by Germany. Hagen, Christoph Hagen dumps it in nicely and chases it down. And Luongo keeps the play going to Stoiko, approaching 4 minutes remaining in the third period. Labonte to Escott. Escott, Musto, not much room, and doesn't keep it in. And he'll have to retreat as his teammates clear the zone. Ghilarducci with the blast. Settles in behind the net for number 22, Stefan Hagen. Vogler. Nicely done up the boards, but Ghilarducci is there. Morenzi, one move, two moves, three moves too many. Hagen now with a nice move to the inside by Wild and lets one rip. But Fabio Luongo there, he has been all night.
Once again, Luongo just steady Eddie between the pipes. Not just making the save, but no rebounds. And whenever there is a rebound, it's in the corner. It's textbook goaltending here.
A definite strength of Team Canada 2013 is their goaltending, led by Fabio Luongo from Montreal, Quebec. Ball goes into the corner, and number 87 will just fall on it, Daniel Brendel, and play will be called. While 3:28 remains in this opening day here in Pool A, results weren't surprising, although Switzerland gave the Czech Republic all they could handle. They look to be a much improved team. Canada doing what they're supposed to do bodes well for the upcoming week as we get ready for the more intense games.
It's certainly going to be a treat when the big four do meet each other later on this week. And I'm really looking forward to that Canada-Slovakia game on Tuesday evening.
Exactly. 8:15 at Jack Byrne Arena. Morenci sends it in behind to Vargas Diaz. He'll send it to Labonte on a nice play, but that doesn't connect. And Cook for Germany. Lofts it up. Gets it out of the zone at least and gets it right back. Brendel still with the ball, tries to send it through. And here comes Labonte, 2-on-1 with Morenci. He'll pass it to Morenci, who'll go to the backhand, and it's foiled by Dürer. Morenci with the nifty play as he puts it on his blade and fools the goalie, and Canada scores their 11th.
That's just ridiculous. That is absolutely ridiculous. What skill by Morenci. I can't think the Germany team is going to be very happy about that goal there, but for the fans in attendance, that's just a treat to watch. What a goal by Morenci.
I agree. The losing team is probably not too fond of that type of goal. However, the fans were definitely appreciative of it, and I didn't think he had the room, but all of a sudden, it's in the net.
I tell you what, if I was Morenci, I wouldn't go too close to that net for the rest of this game.
Well said, well said. Hagen behind the net now as time continues to elapse on opening game for Germany. Hagen battling behind the net. Germany retaining possession. Stefan Hagen now. He'll wrist it towards the net and that'll go wide. As Stoiko. Mateo Stoiko tries to send a pass and almost connects with Stinziani. Hagen now with room and time to Vogler. Vogler has played a great game, in my opinion, for the German team, along with the goalie, despite the score. Vogler shoots, and Luongo makes the save. I'm really impressed by the amount of playing time that Vogler's had to accumulate, and he's been steady in the defensive zone.
Yeah, I don't know if we're keeping a stat on it, but in an 11-0 game, I'm willing to bet Vogler's no worse than a -2 or a -3. That's really, really strong defense.
Number 84 should be a factor for Germany moving forward as they'll regroup after this game. As the whistle is blown, Germany, of course, tomorrow, another tough game. They have to turn it around for 2 p.m. tomorrow afternoon to face Slovakia. Doesn't get any easier for the Germany team as they play two of the favorites in their pool group.
And not a lot of time to regroup here after this one tonight. But hey, that's the way tournament hockey goes. That's what you got to do.
Exactly. Frechette sends it up to Peters. He's got speed, the Saskatchewan native. Peters with time. He'll send it back to Frechette. Wild keeps it in, but deflects off the stick of Frechette and out of play. With 75 seconds remaining in this game, Canada looks to be comfortably ahead 11-0. And Germany, they'd like to get that goal, but maybe tonight they just better be satisfied with just getting out of the rink and preparing for Slovakia. Canada, as I mentioned, they're comfortably ahead. I think this is the type of game that they needed to open up the tournament.
One thing really impressive with the Canadian game tonight is, Dave, the other teams today dominated in play. They had possession of the ball, but the scores remained close for pretty much half the games today, with the exception of the United States-France game. Slovakia and Czech Republic ended up winning by large amounts, but the other teams held with them for a while, whereas Canada, as soon as the ball was dropped, this game was pretty much over almost right away. Canada's dominated there tonight.
Exactly. Canada dominating from start to finish. Into the final minute, Cook. He'll try to send it ahead. Just too far ahead, and Luongo retreats and banks it off the boards for O'Keefe. Less than 30 seconds remaining in this game. O'Keefe in no rush. We'll send it up to Peters. Peters gains a zone, and he'll just shoot it towards the net where Dürer will make one of his many saves tonight. Van gets it out of the zone. Sparks gains a zone. Less than 10 seconds remaining. A good start for Coach Iannito as Canada up 11-0 with a whistle. The clock runs and the game is over. Team Canada opens the 2013 World Championships of Ball Hockey with an 11-0 whitewash over Team Germany. You're watching the 2013 ISBHF World Ball Hockey Championships from St. John's, Newfoundland, Labrador, brought to you by Bell Alliance. We're proud to present the week-long tournament. Should be a great tournament. Canada off to a great start at Germany's expense. We'll be back shortly. Welcome back to Jack Byrne Arena, the scene of Team Canada's 11-0 thrashing of Team Germany in opening night. Group A, Pool A of the 2013 World Ball Hockey Championships. Teams are shaking their hands and we're proud to have a member of Team Canada in the broadcast booth. Scott Holman from Edmonton, Alberta is here to join us. Scott, how did you see Team Canada tonight, the game against Germany, and how it came out, and how do you feel? Was it the type of game that they exactly needed to open the tournament?
Yeah, 100%. I think off the bat it was a little jittery just because of all the fans in the crowd, but about six shifts in, we really settled down, started getting the chemistry in, and just went from there.
Of course, you were selected to the team, which is a great accomplishment. Maybe let the audience know, you suffered an injury in the pre-training, you know, heading into the tournament, and exactly what happened and how you're dealing with the fact that you have the joy of being selected, but how much you'd love to be on the floor.
Oh, you know, being selected was huge. I've been working out for about 3 years. to come here and just be with the team and the atmosphere was great. And to have the injury, just, you know, freak accident, just planting the foot and hearing the pop, you know, knew something right away was wrong. And really tough to be here and watch the games. But, you know, going to be positive, be with the team, learn what I can, and be there for 2015 in Switzerland.
Exactly. I was just going to mention, despite the injury, you're a big part of this team, you're a big part of this program, and at 28 years of age, you got a few more world championships in you, so you always have that long-term vision. In terms of going forward with the team this week, obviously you know that the competition is fierce with Czech Republic and Slovakia. Hard to gauge an 11-0 win against Germany for things you know that Team Canada might need to work on. But what would maybe one or two things that Team Canada is going to be looking towards to the Greece game that they could maybe step up, that they couldn't achieve today against an opponent that really couldn't keep up with them?
And watching Czech Republic before this and hearing about Slovakia, it's going to be controlled emotion, I think. You know, their power play is amazing. They run at about 70-80%. Those are the teams that win these tournaments. So controlled emotion is going to be huge. And, you know, coaches talk about it day in, day out. So hopefully we can do it. And just, if we have to, have the PK step up and take it down for us.
And finally, obviously, coming from Edmonton, the ball hockey system there, maybe you can let our audience know in terms of where you play your ball hockey, you know, during the season. And, of course, you've had some previous national championship experience as well.
Yeah, you know, I play for the Edmonton Savages in, Edmonton, obviously. It's a great team, just a great group of guys. It's the reason why I'm on the team. It's not always about the hockey, but it's also about the people you play with. So, yeah, we're coming again, Montreal, hopefully take down Montreal, teammates now, but in August they'll be my competitors, so just pretty excited just every year playing Nationals. It's just a great tournament, it gets you ready for Worlds, so just really excited to get there again.
And which leads me into my last question, the time frame for you to come back, you mentioned like Montreal, the National Championships are in August, so what is the time frame for you to be back, maybe not 100%, but where you can help your team?
Well, unfortunately, like, this tournament's too far gone now. I'm told 4 weeks, get an x-ray, see where it's at. Maybe at 4 weeks I can start riding the bike again. So 4 to 6, they're saying. It's going to be a tough 4 weeks, but I'll be there for Nationals and I'll be ready, top shape again.
Excellent, excellent. Well, we wish you all the best of luck. Thank you for taking the time. You're a true Team Canada player, and you'll be in Zug, Switzerland, I'm sure, in 2 years, and you'll enjoy it, and good luck at this year's Nationals.
Awesome. Thanks very much, sir.
You're welcome. Holben from Team Canada. So we'll sign off tonight as Team Canada opens the tournament with an 11-0 victory. Opening day is done, and we look forward to day two at the 2013 ISBHF World Championships, brought to you by Bell Alliant. I'm Elio Pascuzzo. On behalf of Steve Power and all the hardworking volunteers and cameramen and everybody doing internet stats and everybody that works so hard, we'll see you tomorrow. And good night from Jack Byrne Arena.